Okay, we're ready for the worksheet for 9D in the Math 4 course. And again, I came across these inspirational memes from the American Statistical Association, and I thought this one was kind of cool too, that, you know, apparently every company, I guess you should say every larger company needs a good statistician, you know, to try and figure out what's going on within their company on the statistical level. All right, number one, we're talking about a sampling distribution, and ultimately we're looking at sample proportion. In this case, 60% said that they skip breakfast, all right? So we're going to, first of all, say that the, turn my pen on, the mean of the sample proportion is going to be 0.6, that's the 60%. And the standard deviation of this group is going to be the square root of 0.6, and then 1 minus 0.6, which is 0.4. Remember, they're both supposed to add up to 1. And then the group was 500. So we'll put the 500 underneath it. And we get a 0 point, let's see, to the nearest thousandth would be 3 decimal places. 0219 would be 022. Now, if we're going to do this on a curve, we're going to have 0.600. We're going to add 22 every time. 644, 666, and then we're going to, and then we're going to come back and subtract 578 minus 22 is 556 minus 22 is 534. So now we're looking at less than 58% of the time. This is about 58% here, so we're talking about 1% and down. Now, you may recall that between plus and minus 1 is 68%, which means that this is 34% on this side, and everything left of the middle is 50%. So we're talking about the 50% left side without the 34 that's right there. Now, that sounds like about 16%. So let's see what Desmos has to say about it. All right, so why don't we go to Desmos? We've got the 0.6 as the mean, 0.22 as the standard deviation, and everything 0.58 and below. And it turns out to be 18,165, which I think I had said about 16%, so I wasn't too far off. I'll find the probability. So probability, what was that, 18,165, I'm supposed to say it's about 18.2%. Okay, and this is what we're going to be doing with all six of these problems, is we're just going to be doing this same process over and over again, just changing the numbers. All right, the mean here is going to be the 85%. Our standard deviation of the group is going to be the 0.85 times the 0.15. They both add up to 1. And then we have 1,000 orders. That goes on the bottom. And when we run that through a calculator, let's see, nearest thousandth is going to be tenths, hundredths, thousandths, and there's a 2.9 after that, so we're not going to round up. So now we get to draw the curve, which is going to start at 850, and we're going to go up by 11, and another 11. This one should be fairly easy. And down by 11, which is 39. And then down by 11:28, down by 11:17. Now, they say 82% or less. Wow, look at that. That's way down here. This is almost to the third. We're going to wind up with, you know, maybe a couple of percent at best. Yeah, 1 or 2% at best. So let's see what Desmos does. Okay, and on Desmos, wow, it was even less than 1%. You would call this a 0.3%. That's less than 82, right? 82% or less. All right, so that would be probability 0.3%. Okay. Number three. The mean would be the 56%. The standard deviation is going to be the square root 0.56. That would be 0.44. They would add up to be 100. And let's see, you had a poll of 1,600 children. And Mr. Calculator, to three decimal places, says 0.012. There's a 4 that comes after that, so we're not rounding up. And so we're going to go over here, and we're going to say 560, and we're going to add 12 each time. And then we're going to subtract 12. Now, they're saying less than 53%. That's the 53% right there. And 95% lives between plus and minus 2. So we're talking, you know, and that's 5% left over split between the two sides. That's 2.5%. We're probably talking maybe 1 or 2% here. So let's see. Let's see what happens when we do that. Okay, so we check with Desmos, and Desmos is giving us, again, a very small percentage. It was less than the 1 or 2% that I was guessing. It was 0.6. Now, how will the sampling distribution change if the selected sample was only 400? Remember that the larger the number is on the bottom, the smaller it gets, which means that our sampling distribution, they're really talking about the graph here. The graph will, you know, the standard deviation will not be as big, or excuse me, standard deviation will get bigger. It will get wider and it will get flatter. And that's probably wider and flatter. Because when you raise that bottom number, that means that your standard deviation gets smaller and it gets skinnier and taller. The graph gets skinnier and taller. This is going to have the exact opposite effect. All right, three down, three to go. Oh, let's see, 15,000 students, 73%. Do not get 8 hours of sleep. All right, so your mean of the sample is 73, and your standard deviation would be 73 times 27, over a sample of 15,000. And the calculator is showing, let's see now, to the thousandth is still three decimal places, 0.003 and then a 6. So we're going to say 0.004. 36 bumps the 3 up to a 4. All right, so we're looking at 730 in the middle, and then we're going to add 4 each time. Wow. And we're going to subtract 4. We're talking about between 70 and 75%. That looks like it covers almost the entire spectrum there. This will be interesting to see how close to 99 this thing gets. All right, so we go to Decimus. And Lord have mercy, I wasn't kidding. That is 99.1234 9s and a 7. I think I'm going to list it that way just for the pure spite of it. One, two, three, four, 7%. That's that just blows my mind. Okay. And I'm trying to think about, you know, real picture here. You know, all right, so you go out and you get yourself a fresh sample of 15,000 students. And if the study conducted by CDC, which, why they're studying sleep habits, I'm not really sure, but anyway, you know, they are almost 100% sure that they'll find between 70 and 75% of the students did not get 8 hours of sleep. The figure of how many did not get 8 hours, 100% chance that it falls between 70 and 75%. That's the confidence that they have in this. All right, number next. So we have a 51% chance that they like Brussels sprouts. Great. All right, so your mean there is 0.51. Your standard deviation is going to be 0.51 times 0.49. And there was a sample of 300 people. All right, the calculator says 0.0288. We're going to say 0.029. And that's where we're going to base our graphing on, 510, and then we're going to add a 29, and add another 29, and add another 29, and we're going to subtract a 29, that's going to be without 19, that's that, and then subtract 29 from that. It's going to be 52, and then it's going to be 423. So now we're talking about more than 55%. Well, see, 55 is going to fall somewhere in here. So we're talking about probably, let's see now, this is 50%, and from there over would be 50 without 34, which would be 16. So we're probably talking about, I don't know, 10%, give or take. So let's see what Decimus says. And according to Decimus, I wasn't too far off base. 8.4%, really. I'd guessed 10%, and I said probably on the underside of that. So 8.4, I think, counts. So we're going to say 5.4%. And then number last, let's get this one done. People, 68% prefer to eat the chocolate Easter bunny's ears first. Oh, I have a great meme on that, but anyway, not today. All right, the mean of the sampling distribution is going to be 0.68. That is going to be 0.68, and it would be 32 that would add up to make 1. And we had a sample of 26.25. Now let's see what the calculator says. And this time the calculator gives us 0.009 with a 1 afterwards, so we're not rounding up. And so we come over here and we mark the 680, and then we add 9, and another 9, and another 9, and we subtract a 9, and subtract a 9, and subtract a 9. All right, so they're saying more than 65%. Yeah, that's going to be close to 100% of this group, because 65% is down here. So it's going to be a ridiculously large number. Let's see what Desmo says. Okay, and survey says 99.957. So we'll call that 99.96. And that is it for that worksheet.